Alleluia. Alleluia. We worship you, Jehovah. We give you all the glory, Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you, Jesus, for your great grace, for your loving kindness, for your mercies. We worship you, Lord. Glory, hallelujah. We give you praise, Jesus, who is like unto you. Thank you, Father. You've been with us all the way. We cannot do without you, Lord. You are our everything. Jesus, we wait for your appearing, Lord. We wait on you. You are our hope. We put our trust in you. We wait on you. Thank you, Jesus. Father, come and start with us. Come and change our story. Come and visit us afresh. Come and give us the grace to make profit labors. Ah, may we not toil in vain. Father, we need your divine visitation. Help us to make the work of our hands profitable, Lord. In all we do, in all our ways, we plead for your mercy and your direction. And your help, oh Lord. For you are our help even in time of trouble. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, forgive us our sins. Purify our lives with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Redeemer, for we give you praise. Hallelujah. Be thou exalted, Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. You are welcome once again tonight. Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. Tonight is the 27th night. We thank Abba Father for his great grace. Amen. Hallelujah. We are going to look into the scripture. Praise the Lord. According to Psalm 113. 7-8. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Psalm 113:7-8. Amen. He raises the poor from the dust and lifts the needy from the ash heap. He seats them with princesses. Amen. With the princesses of his people. Amen. Thank you, Lord. He raises the poor from the dust. Not even from the sand. From an impossible state. In the eyes of man. Raising somebody from the dust. Somebody in a pitiable state. That is the God we are serving. Hallelujah. That is the great God that we are serving. Amen. He is in the business of changing lives. Amen. He is the business of changing our story. Amen. He is in the business of turning everything that the enemy has done against us to put us to zero level. To make raise it up to highest level. Because he is God. Amen. All power belongs to him. Solutions belong to him. Healing is in his hands. The great restorer. The great transformer. The miracle working God. He is the God we are talking about. Hallelujah. He is the miracle working God. Amen. The God that can do all things. Amen. The God that has the power to change every impossible situation. Hallelujah. I want us to look into the book of Haggai 1:6. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The book of Haggai 1. Verse 6, amen. He says, you have planted much, but harvested little. You eat, but never have enough. You have planted much, but harvested little. You drink, but never had your fill. You have planted much, but harvested little. You have put in much, and yet your harvest is little. You have put in much, and yet nothing to show for it. You have put in much. In labor, in dedication, and yet nothing to show for it. Something must be responsible. Amen. Something must be behind it. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. But tonight, we are going to tackle it. Our God is going to change the situation. Amen. Hallelujah. God's desire for me and you is that we shall have enough for ourselves to give to others, especially the needy. His desire for you and me is that we shall have enough for ourselves to support his kingdom work and to give to others, especially the needy. When you are alive and you are seeing people suffering and you cannot do anything, my brother, my sister, is an error. When we are alive and we are laboring, we are struggling, and yet we cannot support the work of God, it is an error. When you are alive, you are toiling, you cannot feed the hungry, is an error. Praise the Lord. His desire for you and me is that we shall have enough for ourselves to support others that are in need, to support his kingdom work. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. I want us to look into another portion of the Bible. We just read Haggai 1:8 right now. Hallelujah. That said, Haggai 1:8, that said, you have sown much. You have sown, you have planted much, but harvested little. You are putting your time, you are putting your energy, you have even dedicated, you don't even have time for anything apart from that thing you are doing, and yet you have harvested little. It is an error. You have planted much, you have put in much, yet you cannot feed well, yet you cannot help the needy, yet you cannot help the work of God. Not because you don't like to do so, but because you are limited financially. Is an error. Tonight, our God is going to change our story. Tonight, there is going to be a divine visitation. Tonight, we are going to connect to his great power. He is going to change everything that the enemy has sown in our lives. He is going to break every barrier, barrier of limitation, barrier of lack of multiplication, barrier of distraction, barrier of unfruitful soil. Barrier of hindrance here and there. Barrier of failure at the edge of breakthrough. When it seems that you are about to make it, something will just occur and bring you back to zero level, to waste your effort. The Lord will avert it tonight. The Lord is about to change your story in the name of Jesus. There's going to be a divine visitation in your foundation. There's going to be a change of status tonight. Hallelujah. I feel so strong in my spirit because my God that I'm serving, your God that you are serving, he's in the business of changing lives. Amen. I want us to open another portion of the Bible. In Proverbs 10:22. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Proverbs 10:22. Amen. Thank you, Lord. It says, the blessings of the Lord brings wealth without painful toil. The blessings of the Lord brings wealth without painful toys. What is painful toys? You deny yourself of the comfort that God has given you. You toil, you put in your life into it. No time for evangelism, no time for the work of God, no time for gathering of the saints, no time to even counsel people, no time to visit the poor and the sick. You put in your best, living to make a living, just living for that your job, just living for that your career, and after everything, nothing to show for it, no investment, nobody you can point at that I trained this person, God used me to help this person, I was used to feed the poor and to feed the needy. My dear, when such a thing is happening in your life, is an error. Amen. Even though there is a stage of planting and there is a level of harvesting, tonight God is going to look into our situation. Hey, you are busy working any contract here and there. At the end of the day, problem will come and carry the money. Fiam, you start from zero level. It's an error. It's an error. Hallelujah. You are busy gathering here and there, and at the end of the day, sickness will come, problems will come, and waste your labor. That will not be your portion. Amen. The Lord is going to give you a divine visitation tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. We are going to start by doing the needful. We are going to beg God to have mercy upon us. We have sinned against Him in so many ways. We have been busy gathering without hearing those assignments He wants us to do. We have been busy gathering no kingdom value. We didn't have value for kingdom work. We didn't have value to alleviate poverty and help the needy. But all for ourselves, we buy the best of cars. We live in high expensive mansion. We waste food and resources. We spend our money on what we never needed. We are busy shopping for unnecessary things. Some people, the money they use on shopping for irrelevant things can train a whole village, can help a whole village, can help a whole kindred. We are going to beg God for forgiveness. We are going to beg Him to come into our life, to come and have mercy. We have done so many things wrong. Let us pray, begin to talk to God as we are talking to Him and talking to Him as well. Father, have mercy. Have mercy, oh Lord. We have sinned against You. So many of us, the Lord raised you in your family to raise life. But you have been so self-centered. Many lives have wasted because you never cared. The Lord have appointed you in that ministry to be a financial supporter. But that has not been your concern. Maybe the Lord have raised you in that community to use you to change lives, but you have never been bothered. Many have been dying in that community. Many lives have been wasted because you never preach to anybody. Tonight, we are going to ask Him for mercy. Maybe you are in that ministry. You have been busy struggling for position. struggling for respect, struggling for honor, causing confusion, and you forget to do the needful. You forget to realize the reason why God took you there. We are going to ask God for mercy. Hallelujah. It can be your marriage. The Lord brought you and your partner together to be a terror to the kingdom. But instead of teaming together, you are busy finding fault here and there. And souls are perishing. We are going to cry to God for mercy. God cannot bless a man that will not use that will not use that blessing to be a prophet to his kingdom. When God look at your life and know that if he put much in you, it will be wasted. He will look away from you. Tonight we are going to beg him. Father, come back to me. I have made up my mind to do the needful. I have made up my mind to serve you. I have made up my mind to do your will, oh Lord. I want you to pray this prayer very well. Father, purify us with the blood of Jesus. Have mercy on us, oh God. Do not remember our old ways. Some of us have been very dedicated to God in the time past. But the moment we were blessed, we forgot about him. Some of us, the Lord sent you outside your nation as a missionary. But when you get there, you get to know the taste of greener pastures. You forget about him. You throw your Bible one side. Tonight, we are going to beg him. Some of us, when you were starting that career, you made one promise or the other to God. Oh, Father, only if you bless me, I will do this, I will do that. But when he blessed you, what did you do? You forgot about your oath. You forgot about the covenant. Tonight, his mercy shall prevail in the name of Jesus. Hey, there's going to be a new beginning in our lives in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. New beginning, amen. New beginning in the name of Jesus. We are going to pray tonight, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But there is hope. There is hope. The word of God says in Psalm 30, verse 5, he said, for his anger endureth but a moment. In his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Hallelujah. God is starting afresh with you. Amen. He will do a new thing. Amen. I want your faith to be strong tonight, because God is about to do a new thing in your life, in my life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. In Psalm 34, verse 9 and 10, he said, oh, fear ye the Lord, all ye his saints. He said, for there is no lack for them that fear him with godly fear. In time, the young lion may suffer lack, but they that fear the Lord shall not lack anything good. That shall be your story tonight. Tonight, as you make up your mind to fear him, tonight, as you make up your mind to come back to him, he's going to change your story. He will change your situation. He will make all things beautiful. Amen. For you have suffered enough. For you have dwelt on that mountain for long. Amen. I want us to pray. I want us to pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. We are going to pray. Say, oh Lord, my Father, grant me favor in the hand of those that you have given the grace to be used as vessel to move me to the next level. Pray this prayer. You need the favor of God. I need the favor of God. Father, come and release your great favor upon our lives, in the heart of our employers, in the heart of our leaders, in the heart of our business partners, in the heart of men that we are seeking contracts from. Come and release your favor even in the lives of our children, because if it's well with our children, it shall be well with us. Open your mouth and pray this prayer. The Lord shall favor you. He shall favor your family. He shall favor your marriage. Whatever you lay your hand to do, from tonight, it will be resourceful. It will be productive. You will get more results. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You are going to pray. I reject the spirit of detail. I reject the spirit of failure. I reject the spirit of not doing well. I reject the spirit of promise and fail. I reject the spirit of unproductive labor. I reject the spirit of poverty. Tonight, the Lord is going to cancel, hallelujah, every mountain that has raised itself against your prosperity, against your fruitfulness. Maybe you have been preaching the word, nothing to show for it. Not so. Tonight, grace is being released in your life in the name of Jesus. Those places that you have failed, from tonight you will go back again. And you shall record success in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We are still praying. Amen. We are still praying. We are going to pray that every record that the enemy has sent to the heart of your helpers, to the heart of your business partners, every evil report, every evil record that the enemy has programmed in the heart of your superiors, in the heart of the people that employed you in the office, that let the power of God cancel such record, cancel such evil reports in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the house tonight. Maybe the enemy have painted you black, have given your partner a false image about you. Your partner is looking at you, he's seeing another person altogether. But tonight, power is coming from above to wipe away every false image that the enemy has given you in the name of Jesus. Maybe you are seeking for a life partner. You have been experiencing some struggle. Only the wrong people come your way. Tonight, by the authority in the name of Jesus, the Lord is releasing the right person in the name of Jesus. They will cross your path. They shall cross your path in the name of Jesus. Maybe you have submitted a lot of quotations here and there. Nobody is calling you. No company is calling you. But from tonight, there's going to be a turnaround in the name of Jesus. They shall call you. They will remember you in the name of Jesus. Maybe the time passed. You have been struggling. You are very strong in making money. You are very gifted. You have all the wisdom to plan, to strategize. You get results, but problems come one way or the other to eat up your fruit, to eat up all that you have gathered. Tonight, by the authority in the name of Jesus, heaven is releasing angels that will recover all that you have lost. I hand them over to you tonight in the name of Jesus. This is your season of upliftment. This is your season of recovery. You shall recover. You shall recover. You shall recover in the name of Jesus. You shall recover in the name of Jesus. You shall recover in the name of Jesus. I want to beg you. Are you watching this program? Are you praying along? Share this prayer. Share it. God will use it to change lives. Don't be selfish about it. Share it because God is about to do something. Hallelujah. May God use you as a vessel to bless life tonight. Share this prayer. I have a confirmation in my spirit that the Lord is about to do something. Hallelujah. We are still praying. We are going to pray. Begin to see yourself in the nation or in the state or in the country where you were born. Maybe forces followed you as you left to make a greener pasture. You are going to command them tonight by the authority in the name of Jesus that every negative power that have followed you as a monitoring agent, by the authority in the name of Jesus, fire from above is coming down to destroy them in the name of Jesus. Every monitoring spirit, every monitoring mirror that the enemy has sent against your life, my Father in heaven is breaking them to pieces. He is breaking them to pieces. He is breaking them to pieces in the name of Jesus. Have you lost your job? I want you to rejoice because tonight power is changing hand. Power is changing hand in the name of Jesus. Where they have rejected you, they will call you back in the name of Jesus. Where they have rejected you, they will honor you in the name of Jesus. Have the enemy push you out of your marriage? Power is changing hand tonight. You shall recover that marriage in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, every stranger in your home shall leave in the name of Jesus. Every stranger in your house that is standing as a spiritual agent working against your progress, tonight they will make up their mind to leave you for good in the name of Jesus. Every power that is taking you away from studying the word of God, they are losing their grip tonight because of God, as you study the word of God, he will open your eyes and give you wisdom. He will open your brain and remove foolishness. He will open your mind.
I just want to tell you what I think.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Now you are into your mouth.
The Lord is a good God. Amen. The Lord is great. Tonight is going to visit our foundation. Tonight, power is changing hands. Amen. Let me tell you this story. Last years in my ministry, I was so dedicated in the work of God. I was so committed, but I was not seeing fruit. I will preach to people, I won't get results. I decided to pray. I decided to break that curse. I decided to cry to God. He changed my story. He changed my story. And I began to notice something. As I minister, God changed lives. That is migrating from the level of profitless labor to the level of a stage where your labor is profitable. Some people walk like elephants and eat like ants. That is not the will of God. Amen. That is not the will of God for us. Amen. Tonight, we are going to beg God. We are still praying. Don't be tired. We are still praying. Amen. Our God will visit us in a special way. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. We are going to pray that let there be a change, transfer of human agents who are found never to allow you to make it in life. It can be in your office. Those that are vowed to make sure that you will not be promoted, let the Lord transfer them to another branch. Let the Lord remove them even from that office. Since good things is not good for them, they need to believe. Amen. It can be in that contract you are pursuing, that contract you are seeking, that project that you want to execute. The enemy positions some people to attack you. Every step you take, they make it very difficult. The Lord is going to do something tonight. There's going to be transfer. Amen. There's going to be a transfer in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Any man, any woman that have vowed not to see the work of God, not to see the great hand of God come to pass in your life, God is going to make them to change their mind. God is going to cause them to be transferred away from your location in the name of Jesus. We are going to pray. Sometimes the enemy uses us against ourselves. You can ask me how. The enemy can use laziness. When you are supposed to move out, you are sleeping. When you are supposed to go 10 miles, you are going 2 miles and you are already tired. The enemy can make you not to work for long hours. Those are the strategies of the enemy. Amen. But tonight, there's going to be a divine visitation in the name of Jesus. The Lord is going to do a new thing in your life in the name of Jesus. He's going to strengthen you. He's going to grant you wisdom from above. He's going to cause men to favor you in the name of Jesus. Sometimes the enemy can cover our favor. People that are supposed to favor you, to work with you, people that are supposed to be a blessing to you, they will begin to detest you. It is not their making. But because the enemy have vowed not to see you do well, only Usually the people that will have problem with you is the one is pushing your way. But from tonight, power will change hands in the name of Jesus. Even in the ministry, you will see people that will walk with you peacefully. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to share this story with you. The first ministerial assignment I had, my first post, in fact, my second posting, I was sent to pastor a church. My friend that was supposed to partner with me, they gang up against me. They were fighting me both on my back and in my presence. At a point, I had to tell them, please, I don't want to do that work anymore. I was like, God, is this how the work of God is supposed to be? People fighting you here and there. I decided to leave that work. It may be your case. Maybe they don't have anything against you, but because powers have vowed not to allow you to do well, they will go and cause problem, cause sin of, source sin of discord, make people to be against you. The office that you are seeking a contract, they will just see you and they say, ah, don't worry, we don't need it anymore. But they need it because monitoring spirits are following you to destroy good things of life over your life. Tonight, power is going to change hand. The Lord is going to cancel every form of distraction in your life. He's going to cancel every seed of negativity in your life. Every seed of failure, He's going to cancel it in the name of Jesus. He will give you power to make words. He will give you wisdom to make words in the name of Jesus. We are going to make a decision tonight. You are going to tell God. You are going to make a covenant with God. That if He bless you, this is what you will do for Him. It is between you and Him. You are not telling me, you are not telling anybody. I want you to tell God something tonight. His ears are open to hear you. Amen. His ears are open. Thank you, Jesus. We are going to pray. Beg God to connect you with the right people. He should connect you to the right people. People that will help to move you forward. People that will want to work with you in unity. People that will protect your interests. It is very, very important. Father, we declare that we love you. We declare with everlasting love for you. Father, we declare that we love you. We declare with everlasting love for you. Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. We declare with everlasting love for you. Hey, this song I'm singing, is it your song? Are you declaring your everlasting love for Him? God cannot bless a man that will not protect his interests. God will not bless a man that will not represent Him well. God will not bless a man that will bring shame to Him. Tonight, I want you to make a declaration. Begin to tell Him how you love Him. Begin to tell Him, what you will do for His kingdom. He wants to hear you. He wants to hear you speak. Amen. Because your story is changing tonight. Amen. I feel it strong in my spirit that God wants to do something. Amen. I want you to pray for your family. Begin to cancel every seed of discord that the enemy have sown. grant you unity in your home. Amen. Begin to beg God to do a new thing. Begin to beg God to repair every broken walls of your life. Begin to beg God to prosper the work of your hand. Begin to beg God to connect you to people that would connect you to get results. Amen. Father, we give you praise. Hallelujah. We worship you because you have answered our prayers. We adore you because you are about to do a new thing. Hallelujah. You are changing our story. You are canceling every poverty in our life. You are canceling favor. You are canceling unprofitless labor. You are canceling every enemy that the devil has planted in our life to pull us back to zero level. Ah, Jesus, we worship you because you are doing a new thing. Hallelujah. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Thank you for your divine visitation tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is giving you new ideas. New ideas that will catapult you to the next level. Amen. Ah, those files you have submitted, God is sending his angels. Hallelujah. He is causing a remembrance to follow suit. Somebody is about to hear good news. Where they have disgraced you, they will call you back to honor you. In the name of Jesus. Where they have rejected you, they will call you back to accept you and to honor you. In the name of Jesus. Those profitless labor is being converted to profitable labor in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you, I am that I am. Your joy is coming back. Hallelujah. Your integrity is coming back. Hallelujah. Your faith is coming back. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I can see everything turning around. Everything turning around. Everything turning around for your good. I can see everything turning around. See everything turning around. Everything turning around for your good. Amen. Those that spoiled you at your back, they will come back to confess. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. And God shall prosper you. He will use you to bless many lives. He will use you to push his kingdom work forward. He will use you to be a blessing to the poor and the needy. In the name of Jesus. That community where you were born, hey, their story is changing because of you. He will use you to raise many lives. In the name of Jesus. I prophesy over your life, hallelujah, that from tonight, the joy of the Lord is coming afresh in you. The Lord is rekindling your evangelical gift. That evangelical spirit he gave you, he is rekindling it afresh. Maybe you have been sitting idle in Zion. He is reviving you afresh, amen, hallelujah. Somebody will burst into tongues tonight. Amen. If the Lord leads you to continue this prayer, please continue. Amen. If the Lord leads you to burst into tongues, to speak in tongues for 1 hour, continue. If the Lord leads you to sing songs of praises, continue. Amen. And it shall be well with you. Glory be to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord is doing a new thing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I prophesy over your life that every failure at the edge of breakthrough is being cancelled over your life in the name of Jesus. I prophesy over your life that those that are owing you, they will call you and they will pay you in the name of Jesus. I prophesy over your life, hallelujah, that those that have messed your name in the back, at your back, they will come back to confess. And they will honor you from today henceforth in the name of Jesus. I prophesy over your life that healing is coming upon your life. The Lord will heal you in your bones. He will heal you in your body. He will heal you in your blood. He will heal you. He shall revive every part of your body that has been eaten up by sickness. The Lord is restoring those body parts of yours that have gotten damaged. Hey! He is restoring you. He is changing them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father, because it is done. I want us to have an agreement prayer. Father, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Thank you for prayer answered. Thank you for changing our story. Thank you for canceling every mark of death upon our life. Thank you for uprooting whatever evil man have planted in our life. Thank you, Lord, because you are going to cause us to be focused in this our pilgrim journey. Amen. You are going to make us lover of your word. You are going to make us doer of your word. You are going to make us people that will join to promote the kingdom work this end time in the name of Jesus. You are going to make us peacemakers. You are going to make us soul winners in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for we are blessed to be a blessing. Father, thank you for using us to touch lives in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Child of God, it is well with you. It is well with you. Rejoice. The Lord has given you victory. Amen. Amen. I want to beg you to share this prayer. You can send it to somebody on WhatsApp. You can send it on Messenger. You can even do a watch party with this prayer. You can share it on your timeline. You can share it to your group. Share it, and the Lord will bless you as He changes lives through this prayer in the name of Jesus. See you next time tomorrow, 11:30 p.m. Nigerian time. Please, I want to beg you, if you try to connect and the line is not connected, be patient. Highest it will take 10 or 15 minutes before the network gets connected. You are blessed. Today is the 27th day. To God be all the glory. Tomorrow, we shall migrate to the 28th day. Hallelujah. You shall testify. You shall finish strong in the name of Jesus. This remaining part of the 50 days prayer. The Lord will keep you strong. He will give you testimony. Hallelujah. Don't give up. God bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Shalom.